Russ Mann here, Vice President of Sales for PermaShield USA. I'm glad you're here. We're going to take a few minutes to demonstrate how easy and simple it is to put PermaShield into a tire. Now, this is my own personal vehicle. This is something I drive every couple weeks when I'm back in town to go around Arizona and meet and talk to dealers all the time. But this particular tire has a slow leak in it. So every time I come home, it's half flat. So I got to get out the compressor. I got to fill it up with air every time. And my wife's been harping on me on it for a while now. So it's going to be great to actually get this filled up. So the process to start is to make sure we have a clean environment. We don't want a lot of debris that can get into the tire or on the valve stem at all. We're going to make sure that the tire itself and the valve stem is between 10 and 2 on a clock. We're going to verify inside of the driver's side door, the PSI that is required to fill the tire back up with air, because we're going to remove the air first before we put in the PermaShield. PermaShield and the pump, will show you how to make sure that you get the right amount of PermaShield in it. And in order for us to do that, we go to the website, PermaShieldUSA.com, and you go to the light duty calculator. The light duty calculator, once you get to that spot, you're going to put in the tire size. Now this particular tire size is 215/60R17. So you'll put those three numbers into the calculator and it'll compute, in this particular case, it's 15 ounces. On this particular tire. So we're going to put 15 ounces of PermaShield in it, and it's only going to take us a couple of minutes, then we're going to drive it, shear it around, we'll be good to go. So first thing we do is we remove, after we know our PSI, we know our amounts, is we remove the core of the valve stem. Obviously, use a small tool to remove the core. Make sure that you don't lose it because it pops out fast. It's got air pressure obviously behind it. So if you're not careful, it'll pop out across the room. Put the core up here on the top. And then while that's airing out, we know that we're going to install 15 ounces of product. So the pump itself has 8 lines on it. Each line is a separate ounce. So because we're 15, we're going to start with 8 and 7. So this top line is 8. Now, we're going to make sure that the bottom of this washer is at the top of this line. So you see the top of my head. Okay. Make sure it's good and tight because you don't want to get too much or too little. For obvious reasons, you get too little, it doesn't produce as well. If you get too much, it'll create a balance issue. The nice part about that is if we do make a mistake on too much, we can simply wipe it out. The product is water soluble. It is made with recycled rubber and Kevlar. So it's very simple and straightforward. It is not sticky, it is not gooey, it is not tar or petroleum based, water based with Kevlar. Key component, very natural. So first thing that we need to do is we need to prime the pump. We need to make sure that the hose is full of product itself. So we're just going to go ahead and get this hose working here and fill it up so that the hose has product, because if the hose doesn't have product in it, you're going to end up not putting the right amount of product in the tire. So we push it right up to the beginning, right up to the top, just so you can see it start to come out, and then we're going to raise the pump all the way to the top. We've already got it marked at 8, and then you just simply put it on the tire. There's a clip. Undo the clip, push the clip down, we're good to go. Now we're going to pump in 8 ounces first. The nice thing about this is not a lot of pressure to it. And then now we're going to pull back up, and we're going to put 7 ounces in it. So we need to move the washer. So when we move the washer, remember the bottom of the washer to the top of the line. So 18 ounces, you would do 6 at 3. So do your math calculations. And then we're going to pump the second one in. Very easy and straightforward. And at this point, when I know I'm done with the product amount, I pull up just a titch to release some of that pressure from the valve. And then I'm going to make sure I got my paper towel. I'm going to take it off of the stem. So as you can see, very easy and straightforward. Be very careful that there's no product left. And then I generally, we'll just hang it back up here. you'll get a little come out of the stem a little bit, but as you can see, we just use a paper towel to clean up. It's very simple and straightforward. So now we're going to put that core back in. Make sure we're good and solid. Pull that out. And then turn the compressor on. So now that's the installation process. We're going to repeat that same process for all four tires, and then we're going to come back and take it for a spin so that you can see how that operates too. Thanks.